Welcome to Detroit Wants to Know. Well, the second presidential debate is done. We had two presidential debates, one vice presidential debate, and many of you still think it's a race to the bottom. Many of you still are not motivated to go out and vote. There's an enthusiasm gap. Donald Trump still has more enthusiasm behind him than Hillary Clinton. Yes, she's leading in the polls. But in order for her to actually pull it off on election day, you, Detroit, are going to have to turn out. Let me give you the reasons why you have to turn out. Number one, anybody that wants to reinstitute stop and frisk, I don't care if it's just for Chicago, I don't care what he says about that, anybody even thinks that way, you have a problem. Stop and frisk has been ruled unconstitutional. It's a bad thing. And you don't need anybody who thinks that way. Reason number two, do you really want somebody that's up at 3 a.m. tweeting to actually deal with Kim Jong-un or his successor in North Korea? Do you really want that? That's two reasons to vote. And you say, well, Steve, she lies a lot. He lies a lot, too. Get over it. Right now, she is 17 points behind in enthusiasm where President Barack Obama was back in 2012 at this time. You have to fire it up. In order not to have a Trump presidency, you're going to have to turn out to vote. And that means you're going to have to get your friends out to vote. Now, on another subject, we have a RESA enhancement millage coming up countywide. You need to read up on it, all right? It's throughout Wayne County. You need to read up on this millage because this is what the Detroit Public Schools needs to fix those buildings and do the repairs that are necessary. The state did not give them enough money in that quote-unquote bailout. There was not enough money there to actually get it right. We need this enhancement millage. Detroit needs it. Your children need it. We've got good enrollment numbers. We need to keep it going. Last week, I showed you a farm. I showed you a farm at the Transition Center, a farm on Wyoming. I showed you how they're training people with IQs of 50 and below to till the farm, harvest the produce. I showed you how that food was actually used inside of DPS. That was just one section of DPS. That's one part of the greatness of DPS that Bill Schuette and Natasha Baker want to shut down. You need to write them and tell them, hands off DPS. Hands off. DPS is moving. DPS CD is moving. Finally, the school board race. Over 60 people are running in this race. You need to vet the candidates. And you need to have your stamina ready to go. Early voting has begun. If you're going to vote early, it's begun. Get your stamina together. Get through that ballot. Get through that ballot all the way. But know who you're voting for. Don't just vote for a name. Vote for somebody that's going to do the work. I'm not going to tell you how to vote. Just go ahead and do it. Today, we're coming to you from the Red Velvet Room at Beans and Cornbread in Southfield. Southfield has become one of the havens for African Americans that have chosen to leave Detroit. We're going to get an in-depth look at it from my good friend Bill Latimore later on the show. But first, I'm going to introduce you to a judicial candidate, great young lady, Kamesha D. Gant. She's going to be in our second segment. My friends, stick around. It's about Southfield this week. And also, at the end of the show, Patric Coleman is going to unveil something new, the owner of Beans and Cornbread. Amazing guy. He's got something new that's happening. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back. When we come back, I'm going to introduce you to Kamesha Gant.
With 20 top surgeons performing over a dozen of the latest knee, hip, and joint procedures at the hospitals you know and trust, we only have one question. Where does it hurt? Orthopedics and sports medicine at the DMC. Call 888-DMC-2500. The DMC's sports medicine specialists, the official docs of our Detroit Red Wings. With offices throughout Southeast Michigan and more than 30 rehabilitation locations, we can make you feel better in all these places. Call 888-DMC-2500.
Mike's Fresh Market, Detroit's largest independent supermarket with the best prices, quality, and service. Enjoy our vast selection of fresh fruits and vegetables. Wide aisles lead you to our own in-house bakery and deli. Beef, pork, chicken, seafood, and much more. You can rest assured you will feed your family the freshest food in town. Whatever you need, you can find it here at Mike's Fresh Market. Mike's Fresh Market, with two locations, Gratiot and 7 Mile and Livernois and 7 Mile. Better food, better prices. That's Mike's promise.
Always there when I needed. You could just call him. All I had to do was find ways to heal. And the legal side, Mrs. Johnson said, you don't worry about that. I have that taken care of for you.
When you pick him, you're picking a family member, because that's exactly what he treats you like, a family member.
It's personal, but yeah, he was right there. It's like he's been in my life all my life.
My name is Lakia Costner.
I'm Dan Rolster.
I'm Craig Rose. Ben Johnson fought for me, and he will definitely fight for you.
Hello, I'm Dr. Shauna Diggs, and welcome to Cosmetic Dermatology.
As Michigan's leader in comprehensive skin health and rejuvenation, board-certified dermatologist Dr. Shauna Ryder Diggs and the entire Cosmetic Dermatology team take a caring, customized approach to skin care. The Cosmetic Derm team effectively treats skin diseases and autoimmune diseases, such as lupus. State-of-the-art laser technology is utilized in hair removal, tattoo removal, and skin peels. To learn more, visit our website, Cosmetic Dermatology, where science and beauty meet.
What is DTE Energy doing to help support Michigan communities?
They support a lot, like the National Cherry Festival in Traverse City, Art Prize in Grand Rapids, not to mention help fund the Career Technology Center at Monroe County Community College. And also helping make the streets of Detroit safer.
Wow, that's a lot.
You're telling me, I'm exhausted. DTE Energy, know your own power.
Good morning. Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you from the Red Velvet Room at Beans and Cornbread in Southfield. My guest this segment is Kamesha D. Gant, candidate for 46th District Court. Hello. Madam Gant.
Hello.
Welcome. You've been on the radio show a couple times. You made it through the primary. Now you're at the big dance.
Oh, yes.
You're at the big dance. How does it feel? First time candidate, making it through the primary, beating a lot of established people. How does it feel?
Feels really great. It was a tremendous accomplishment, and I couldn't be happier with the performance that my team and I had on the day of the primary, and the help of the people that got me to this point. So I'm truly grateful.
I have a lot of Southfield viewers, and I have a lot of Detroiters that end up in 46th District Court. Okay, for traffic violations or whatever. Why should they elect you?
I think they should elect me because I'm a well-qualified, well-rounded candidate. I think I'm the best candidate for this position. The 46th District Court deserves someone on the bench that is experienced in all of the types of cases that the 46th District Court handles. That would be me. And the 46th District Court deserves someone who has the ties to the community to be able to better serve the people that come through the 46th District Court. And I have those ties. So I think that if someone were to vote for me on November 8th, they couldn't go wrong because I am the best of the two.
Where'd you go to school?
I went to the University of Michigan for undergrad, and I went to Wayne State University Law School. I grew up in Lansing, Michigan.
So where do you go to church?
I am a member of the Holmes Road Church of Christ, and that's actually in Lansing, Michigan. They do have some Church of Christ in this area as well.
So do you go back and forth to Holmes Road?
I did. My parents still live in Lansing, so I would use the opportunity to go back and forth to see them and to attend my home church. I also visit churches in this area as well.
A lot of Detroiters find themselves in 46th District Court. What kind of experience will they have in your courtroom?
if they come in my courtroom, they know that they're going to get somebody who's on time. They're going to get someone who is prepared. They're going to get someone who is going to be experienced. And they're going to get someone who is going to be respectful of everyone that comes in there, the attorneys and the litigants. They're also going to get someone who's going to be fair, impartial, take each case as they come in on an individual basis, and someone who's going to have compassion.
How are you going to avoid what I like to call judicial arrogance on the bench? It's 3 years in, you're sitting there. How are you going to maintain being grounded in the community?
My family is very grounded. They're laborers. We've always had to work hard for what we have in life. And my parents have instilled in me that you never take anything for granted and you always are grateful for another day to live. So if I get this position, I'm here because of the people and that they elected me, and then I wasn't handpicked and selected by a governor. And I would never take advantage of that, and I would be there to serve the people. So the judicial arrogance is not something that would even be in my character.
That's good to know. That's good to know. I mean, because it gets scary sometimes in court. It doesn't get scary for me because I just like looking funny at judges. All right. But it gets scary for some people, and they're afraid they're not going to be treated right, especially when it's in a different town. What's in a different town? What other attributes, real quick, do you bring to the court?
Well, I'm someone who has had her own law firm for the past 10 years. I've served the public with criminal defense, civil, and I've also done work at the juvenile court. So they're getting someone who's, like I said, well-rounded and is experienced in all of the types of cases that the 46th District Court handles. I'm extremely hardworking. I travel around the state, so I'm a trial attorney, and I've been in various courthouses in the state of Michigan. So I've seen a lot of things, and there's not many cases or situations that are going to come up that would surprise me. So I think that the people they're going to be refreshed. I'm something new, I'm something different, and I think that that's what they need.
Okay, look into that camera right there. Tell people how to contact you.
You can contact me by my website. It's electgant46judge.com. You can also contact me by email, and that is electkamesha, K-A-M-E-S-H-I-A, middle initial D, Gant, G-A-N-T, gmail@gmail.com.
Great job. Kamesha D. Gant, thank you for coming on the show. Hopefully I won't get arrested in Southfield, so we won't have to test all that stuff.
Oh, well, if you come into the courtroom and I'm on the bench after November 8th, then you'll get someone who's going to be fair and impartial.
Yeah, but I'll probably be guilty if I make it into court. We'll be right back with my good friend, Bill Latimore.
When you're having a heart attack, this is how it feels to your heart. And if it happens at night or on the weekend, there's only one hospital team standing by on site to save you. Cardio Team 1, only at the DMC.
If you or a loved one needs help, call the Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority at 1-800-241-4949. The Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority is your provider for services when you need a hand. We provide services for your whole family in substance abuse, autism services, and parent support. We are there to help with people suffering from depression, anxiety, and those with developmental disabilities. We can assist you with a variety of your mental health care needs. Housing placement for the homeless, job placement, and prescription coverage. As the largest mental health care organization in the state, it is our job to care for you from the neck up. We are the source for all your mental health needs. We are there for you and your entire family. Call us at 1-800-241-4949 or visit our website at dwmha.com.
Mike's Fresh Market, Detroit's largest independent supermarket with the best prices, quality, and service. Enjoy our vast selection of fresh fruits and vegetables. Wide aisles lead you to our own in-house bakery and deli. Beef, pork, chicken, seafood, and much more. You can rest assured you will feed your family the freshest food in town. Whatever you need, you can find it here at Mike's Fresh Market. Mike's Fresh Market with two locations, Gratiot and 7 Mile and Livernois and 7 Mile. Better food, better prices. That's Mike's promise.
Hello, I'm Dr. Shauna Diggs, and welcome to Cosmetic Dermatology.
As Michigan's leader in comprehensive skin health and rejuvenation, board-certified dermatologist Dr. Shauna Ryder Diggs and the entire Cosmetic Dermatology team take a caring, customized approach to skin care. The Cosmetic Derm team effectively treats skin diseases and autoimmune diseases, such as lupus. State-of-the-art laser technology is utilized in hair removal, tattoo removal, and skin peels. To learn more, visit our website, Cosmetic Dermatology, where science and beauty meet.
Always there when I needed. You could just call him. All I had to do was find ways to heal. And the legal side, Mrs. Johnson said, you don't worry about that. I have that taken care of for you.
When you pick him, you're picking a family member, because that's exactly what he treats you like, a family member.
It's personal with him. He was right there. It's like he's been in my life all my life.
My name is Lakia Costner.
I'm Dan Rolster.
I'm Craig Rose. Ben Johnson fought for me, and he would definitely fight for you.
Groundbreaking, life-saving, history-making. The new DMC Heart Hospital, summer 2014. The beat goes on.
Detroit Wants to Know is sponsored by the AFPD, the voice of independent retailers.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you from Beans and Cornbread. We're coming to you from the Red Room. I always like to call it the Red Room. I always love it. But anyway, I have my good friend Bill Latimore with me. He's a former city councilman, been a friend of my family for years, great guy. I'm trying to get the lay of the land in Southfield and how it's changed. Bill, welcome to Detroit Wants to Know.
Steven, see you. I see you out here all the time, but I don't see you on your show, but I'm glad to be here.
I know, I'm incognito when I'm out here. You're not supposed to be seeing me when I'm out here, okay? I slide under the radar. So what's going on in Southfield, man? I mean, it seems to have changed so much. It's now 80% black. It wasn't that way when you were here.
No, I moved out here about 15 years ago, and it has changed. The paradigm has changed as well. We came out here, and right in the midst of the election for Brenda Lawrence, mm-hmm. of which I,
when she was running for mayor.
When she was running for mayor, and the first time, and was the coordinator for that campaign. And since then, it has changed. This used to be a more diverse area mm-hmm. with white, black, Chaldean, mm-hmm. Jewish, predominantly. Mm-hmm. And now a lot of those people are gone and are gone west and north of here, and then we have a lot of people here now from Detroit, as you said, that migrated from Detroit. There's been several turnovers of population here in Southfield.
Well, I think it's interesting that you go from a Mayor Fracassi, mm-hmm. all right, who used to rule the Iron Fist from the back of his restaurant, mm-hmm. to, what's this new guy's name?
Well, you know, you got a guy now that's
Cyber.
Served with me on council, Ken Cyber.
Cyber.
And that's just to show you what the changes have been here.
Well, it's a massive change.
Massive change. Because Fracassi sat as mayor for 29 years before mm-hmm. Brenda took over. Brenda was a mayor for, 14 years.
Right. And so then you had Cyber.
Now we have Cyber. Right.
What a change.
Yeah. Council has changed, too.
Council has really changed.
It has changed.
It's really changed.
So the complexion has changed out here. The politics has changed. This used to be a very sleepy bedroom community, as Brenda used to call it. Okay, it isn't anymore. It's very, very political out here. South Oakland County has changed, where it's become more democratic out here in South mm-hmm. Oakland County, or in Oakland County, period, and the politics has changed. And I attributed most of that to Barack Obama. Barack Obama changed the game out here as far as democratic politics are concerned. Mm.
Everything's changed, but how about the quality of life?
The quality of life is still good here. Like I said, there's been a lot of turnover here. Mm-hmm. Back in 2009, 2010, during the bubble, you had a lot of foreclosures here in Southfield. That's changed. A lot of people after that saw an opportunity to get good housing cheaper, and they bought up all these properties here. If you go to the market, to the realtors right now, you won't see very many available properties here in Southfield. You won't.
Prospects for the future?
The future looks bright for Southfield and this community out here. Some people would disagree with that. You know, some people say, you know, if it's white, it's all right. Mm-hmm. But I'm of the opinion that strong black communities can thrive. Mm-hmm. And this community is thriving. It's going to remain diverse. we have a white mayor, we have a predominantly black council. It is a strong council form of government. Mm-hmm. And I think we, as we have in the past, we're gonna go forward. We're gonna go forward here.
Okay. Bill Latimore, I wanna thank you. Any closing words you wanna give?
No, get your souls to the polls. Take your souls to the polls. Steve was saying it earlier, a very, very important election this year. If you don't wanna move to Canada, you need to go to the polls and vote and get it done. No excuses. This is our opportunity, particularly for African Americans, to make an impact, because we are the biggest vote and most important vote for the Democratic Party, at least anyway. And we need to get out there and vote and make it happen.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back. We're gonna go talk to Patric Coleman. He's got something brand new to show us. We'll be right back.
If you or a loved one needs help, call the Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority at 1-800-241-4949. The Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority is your provider for services when you need a hand. We provide services for your whole family in substance abuse, autism services, and parent support. We are there to help with people suffering from depression, anxiety, and those with developmental disabilities. We can assist you with a variety of your mental health care needs. Housing placement for the homeless, job placement, and prescription coverage. As the largest mental health care organization in the state, it is our job to care for you from the neck up. We are the source for all your mental health needs. We are there for you and your entire family. Call us at 1-800-241-4949 or visit our website at dwmha.com.
What is DTE Energy doing to help support Michigan communities?
They support a lot, like the National Cherry Festival in Traverse City, Art Prize in Grand Rapids, not to mention help fund the Career Technology Center at Monroe County Community College. And also helping make the streets of Detroit safer.
Wow, that's a lot.
You're telling me. I'm exhausted. DTE Energy, know your own power.
Mike's Fresh Market, Detroit's largest independent supermarket with the best prices, quality, and service. Enjoy our vast selection of fresh fruits and vegetables. Wide aisles lead you to our own in-house bakery and deli. Beef, pork, chicken, seafood, and much more. You can rest assured you will feed your family the freshest food in town. Whatever you need, you can find it here at Mike's Fresh Market. Mike's Fresh Market, with two locations, Gratiot and 7 Mile and Livernois and 7 Mile. Better food, better prices. That's Mike's promise.
With 20 top surgeons performing over a dozen of the latest knee, hip, and joint procedures at the hospitals you know and trust, we only have one question. Where does it hurt? Orthopedics and sports medicine at the DMC. Call 888-DMC-2500. The DMC's sports medicine specialists, the official docs of our Detroit Red Wings. With offices throughout Southeast Michigan and more than 30 rehabilitation locations, we can make you feel better in all these places. Call 888-DMC-2500.
Always there when I need it. You could just call him. All I had to do was find ways to heal. And the legal side, Mrs. Johnson said, you don't worry about that. I have that taken care of for you.
When you pick him, you're picking a family member, because that's exactly what he treats you like, a family member.
It's personal, but yeah, he was right there. It's like he's been in my life all my life.
My name is Lakia Costner.
I'm Dan Roster.
I'm Craig Rose. Ben Johnson fought for me, and he would definitely fight for you.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. You know, we've been out to Beans and Cornbread a few times these years, and every time we come out, he's got something new. The last time I was out here, it was the Brooklyn burrito, this vegetarian burrito thing that killed me. That was awesome. It didn't kill me. It just was like killing it. Amazing, amazing, amazing dish. And today, Patric Coleman has something new to show me. Patric Coleman, empresario, the man of Beans and Cornbread. What do you have to show me?
Hey, Steve, how are you?
I'm great, baby.
You know what? Beans and Cornbread is hitting the streets. We have what we call our soul roll.
Soul roll.
And so this is our food truck. This is what we're doing now at Beans and Cornbread. We have hit the streets. We can bring you all of your classic soul food favorites, and it will travel. We'll roll.
Are those speakers I see on it?
Those are speakers. You gotta have some entertainment, right? I mean, the whole soul food vibe is all about good food, good company, a little bit of music. So absolutely, we have music.
So what kind of food do you serve out of this?
Well, you know what? We were over at a corporation today, and folks, this is perfect for corporations. This is perfect for family events, tailgating. But we were at a corporate event today, and we did our swamp thing. And basically, that is a catfish fillet over a bed of rice. We smother it with gumbo, little collard greens, and we crown it with Cajun shrimp. So just think about everything that's in the swamp is on your plate, except for the dead body and the tires.
Swamp thing.
Swamp thing.
But you do your traditional, like, chicken and waffles?
We do chicken and waffles off the truck. We do shrimp and grits off the truck. The menu changes periodically. So if you're interested in booking the food truck, you can call us at 248-208-1680 or go to beanscornbread.com and you can find more information there.
Let's say I'm going to have a Halloween party, per se, just hypothetically, and I wanted this thing to pull in my driveway and sit there and serve my friends. Would you do that? What's the fewest amount of friends that you would serve with this?
Well, first of all, am I invited to the party?
Oh, that's hypothetically. I don't party anymore.
Well, here's the deal. Mm-hmm. Here's the deal. It's normally about 25 to 30, the minimum, uh-huh. but we're very flexible. So give us a call and we can discuss your options, 248-208-1680.
All right, and I know it goes without saying, you've got all your food handlers cards, you've got all that stuff, so it's totally safe, great cooking. And it's clean, look at this. Look at that.
You know, when we bought this truck, it was pretty ratty. Uh-huh. So we invested in it. And just like our business, we invest. And this truck will create 4 to 5 jobs. So we're job providers, in addition to being restaurateurs.
You've never stopped. You started in Detroit, you're out here, then you expanded this to your takeout, you had the red velvet room, you added the sidecar, and now you've got a truck, the Soul Road.
Well, you know,
Soul Roll.
Yeah, well, you know what, Steve? Millennials, they're not going to come into a restaurant and sit for an hour. Mm-hmm. You have to bring it to them. Everything is going mobile. They're now delivering pizzas by drone. So, you know what? Instead of sitting on our hands waiting for the door to always open, and it does always open, why not take it to the streets? And that's exactly what we've done.
Okay. Patric Coleman, I want to thank you for hosting us again this week.
Steve, it's always a pleasure, and thank you for being here.
And this thing's amazing. I can't wait to hire it.
Folks, book this truck for your next party. So cool.
See how people just take over your show? Ladies and gentlemen, remember, get out and vote. Early voting has begun. Think about what you're voting for, vote, and then come get some soul food from my main man, Patric Coleman.
Thank you, Steve.
We'll see you next week. I'm a soul.